just don't know where this is coming from, because there seems to be absolutely no support for this as being part of our bill and moving forward.
Representative Christensen, you want to take one?
Thank you, Madam Chair. You know, there's a lot of evidence from student groups that have come forward and talked about their opposition to this bill. A lot of these student groups, the students that are coming up to talk against making student activity fees optional, are receiving large stipends from student fees. Students that maybe don't have time to appear here at the Capitol because they're working three jobs to afford the student fees are doing that and pitching their pennies and having to take up more in student loans to pay stipends, and in some cases salaries of people that may or may not be students that are benefiting financially from the student fees.
Senator Blasey.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Just one final comment. Some of these programs do employ students, so it's an opportunity for them to be involved in their social activities, and at the same time, it's a part-time job for them. And, you know, there could have been a letter that was written from these organizations in opposition. I didn't see any. All I saw were positive letters that we should not have this portion in our bill. So I would appreciate the support on that amendment.
Representative Omar.
Thank you, Senator Clausen, for bringing this amendment. I would like to urge a yes vote for this amendment. In committee, we unanimously heard from students, not just student groups, not just people who are giving a stipend. The day that we heard this bill, students were on their spring break, and they came back, left their jobs, to make sure that we heard their voices in opposition to this bill. This is not something that the students asked for. This is not something that the students want. And I think it is our responsibility as representatives, as voices of conscience here in this building, to advocate on behalf of students and their ability to be able to get an educational opportunity that is fully enriching for them. I also would like to point out something that I posed to Representative Christensen in that committee hearing. I would love to see one single email, letter, tweet, Facebook status, anything, any single student that might be working, that might be busy, that might be on vacation, any student who is in support of this bill, I am dying to hear that. I represent the Twin Cities campus of the University of Minnesota, one of the largest campuses, and I have not heard one single student complain about student fees. Every single student who has approached me, and I have a monthly meeting, who has approached me, has talked about the fact that this is not something that they support, this is not something that they want. And I just want to make sure that we are not furthering a policy that is not from the students, that is not for the students, that has not had the proper vetting and counsel from the students. And that just really makes no, that takes really no real account into the need and the benefits that it says that it's supposed to do. It's supposed to be for students, to elevate them from the stress of having to pay this fee, if none of the students are saying that they feel like this is something that they want. And we know that most of these institutions are still going to offer these services. So these fees are going to be absorbed in another way. And so this is a policy that is it in the interest of students? So I urge all of you to vote in support of this amendment.
Senator Johnson.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'd like to thank Senator McClellan.
Austin for his comments. I think that this issue does have pros and cons, and I appreciate Representative Omar's comments. I will say that I have heard from many, many students, just exactly what I suspect Representative Christensen has heard, that they would like to have the payment of such fees be an elective thing and not be a mandatory or required item. My own university experience was greatly enhanced by the payment of an activities fee that did indeed provide things that I might not have chosen. So I think it's an excellent discussion. I'm going to oppose the amendment because I think that Representative Christensen has changed the narrative in regardless of what ultimately happens to this language in regards to activity fees. I think we're all going to be better for it. So I would thank Representative Christensen for putting on the table.
Representative Waller.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and thank you, Representative Christensen, for the bill and for your comments as well, Senator Jensen, and the discussion as a whole. I just wanted to point out a couple things. A lot of the things that I've been hearing relate to some of these fees being really important for services that are administrative, health, academic, and just to be really clear, this wouldn't apply to that. And I can also say that as a larger issue, for me, it's more or less about choice. And so as a former University of Minnesota student, working a lot and involved in my local community, I could have saved, and there are plenty of students that could save money. When we're talking about the skyrocketing cost of student tuition and debt, anything helps. And so if I can save that money and put that towards something else, it's not to say that these programs are going to go away. They can still choose to participate, but then that's their choice when they're choosing where to put their dollars, which I think is a better way to go about this. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Senator Fossen.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I look at this also from the standpoint of the greater good. There are going to be students in the future that won't be able to participate because I would guess that some of these fees are not going to be pay out of your pocket kind of thing. When it's in a fee statement, some of that can be covered by Pell Grants and other ways of accomplishing that. So I think there's an equity issue. I think there's a greater good issue. We all pay taxes, but that doesn't mean that our house is going to burn and we're going to need a fire department. But we all like other areas of paying taxes, roads we drive on, schools, etc. So again, I just think this is taking away a great opportunity for many students, and it will change the face of the university.
Further discussion on the 889 amendment. Senator Fossen removes his motion.